Let's convert your Figma designs into a fully functional website without writing a single line of code. This is the method that I've done so many times to build my clients' websites, and today I'm showing you exactly how to do it using Framer. Framer is a free web design tool that lets you turn your designs into fully functional websites. It offers smooth animations, SEO, and built-in hosting, making it super easy to go from static to live. Let's jump straight into it. I have two simple sections for the website. The first one is the hero, and the second one is a why choose a section. What you want to do is you click on the layer that you want to paste on Framer. The first one, I'm going to do it for the hero section first. I have it selected, right click, open a plugin, search for Figma to HTML with Framer. So it's this plugin, you click it, and then it's going to copy the layers. Once it's done, you'll have this panel here. You click on copy to clipboard, and once it says copy X layers, paste in Framer, you go to your Framer. This is the default view of Framer. So once you start a new project, the breakpoint size is going to be 1200, whereas in Figma, desktop default size is 1440 in width. You want to change this to 1440 first to match the Figma design, and you click on the layer and then just paste Control V. That's my design from Figma. Now you might see that this isn't 100% matching what I have in Figma. If you compare it, you can see how the elements alignment and arrangement are not exactly the same. And this is the thing with the plugin, it's not 100% perfect, but it saves you like 85 to 90% of the work, so you don't have to build everything from scratch in Framer. So once you have this ready, you see that the layers are named just as I name it in Figma. So I have the hero, and then within I have top nav and container. And by the way, all of these are in auto layout. So we have top navigation and container, and then within I have another auto layout here, heading, and then the background I've set here to absolute position. Whereas in Framer, this is the thing I noticed, that when you have an absolute position frame in Figma, it'll paste as relative position in Framer. So you might want to take a note of that. And this is the background here, the rings. This is set to relative. I'm going to change this to absolute, straighten it, and then put this right in the same position as Figma. And now I have the background in the right position, but it's covering my heading. So with Framer, what you want to do if you want to put the layer all the way to the back is you give it a Z index of 0. Now you see that it's still covering my headings, so I'm gonna select the heading layer and go to styles. If you don't see the Z index here, you can click on plus Z index and add a value of 1 or maybe even 2. And that's basically the same thing as what I have here in Figma. Now let's move on to the second section. I'm gonna right click, open the plugin again. It's gonna copy my layers, copy to clipboard, and click on the desktop, on the main container again, and then paste. Now you see that it's not pasted correctly because I haven't set it to a stack. A stack is basically an auto layout in Figma. So I'm gonna Control Z. In order to add a stack, you can just simply click plus on the layout here. So stack means that it's basically auto layout, same thing. You want to make sure that the direction is vertical, distribute start, and then I'm going to give a gap of 0. And now I'm going to paste again the same layer. Now it's pasted exactly the same as I have it in Figma. I'm going to change the height to fit content so we can see everything here. Another thing that I want to point out is that if you take a look here in Figma, I have this frame container of the cards set to fill. And then the outer container, I have set a 120 paddings on left and right side. It's gonna fill in, and then each of the three cards, I've also set them to fill. But once you pasted it on Framer, even though it looks correct, you might wanna inspect everything again, because if I click on this frame here, it's not set to fill, it's set to relative. I'm gonna change this to fill. And then each of the cards within, it's set to fill as well. So sometimes it's set to fill, and sometimes when I set the layers width to fill in Figma, it translates to a fixed width in Framer, so you might want to double check that every single time. This is exactly what I'm talking about. So the text here, the headings, even though it may look like it's failing the container it's set to fix. You wanna like tweak this a little bit. Same thing with these text layers. Both of these are set to fix as well. You wanna change that. And then this one. Another thing I wanna point out is that, so in Figma, I'm using icons here. So this is SVG, right? We have the icon layer, which is an SVG, and then the icon container, and then the purple frame. In Framer, every time I paste an icon, the position is always off a little bit. You can see that it's not perfectly centered in the container. So you wanna manually adjust that. And also, you can't edit this vector because it still has this icon. So in Framer, if you paste an SVG from Figma, you have to double click it in order to change it to this icon right here. And once you see this pen icon, then you can double click and see the individual path, and you can add, change the color, change the stroke width. But before you double click, you're gonna see this icon here. And again, this is not centered, so I'm gonna make sure everything looks nice. Double click if you wanna change the color or make any modifications to the icon. Double click this one again, make it nice and centered, and there we have it. We have the website on Framer, exactly the same as I have it in Figma. If I wanna publish this website, I can just click on the top right button here, says publish. It's gonna load a little bit. And then it says this project has been published to, and they give it a dummy URL. So if I click on this dummy URL, you can see that it loads up in my Google Chrome exactly the same way I have it on the Framer canvas. It's live on the internet. You can share the URL to your friends, your families, and they will be able to access it using the same URL. And it's live on the internet, so it's that easy. Obviously, with the free plan, you'll have this watermark here. And another thing is that you'll have this .framer.app in the URL, so it's gonna give you a random URL here, and then on the tail end, it's gonna have framer.app. You can actually change this, change the domain. I can go to the site settings. So open settings, or you can go to domains. If you're subscribed to a paid plan, you'll be able to connect a custom domain. But if you're not and you're on the free plan, you can also add a free customized domain as long as it's not taken by somebody else. So if I'm gonna say, let's say design agency ABC, I don't know if it's taken or not, click on check mark, and it's not taken, so I can do that. So it's optimized, it's live and running, and now this URL will also work, and people will see the design on Framer if they go to this URL on any of their browsers. So if I click on this, now it's gonna have this new URL called designagencyabc.framer.website, and it's gonna show the same website as the one that you have on the Framer. Now, if you take a look closely here, the links are covered by the background elements that I have here. We want the navbar to be visible. We don't want this to be covered by the decorations. So what we're gonna do is do the same thing as I've done previously at the z-index here. Give it a 3, just to make sure it's always on top of everything. Any changes I make to the Framer site, just so that we can tell the difference. Let's say I'm gonna change this metric here to 99% from 97. So I've made the changes after publishing. Now what I wanna do is click on publish. It's gonna say when was it last published, how many changes there are since, and I can click on update. It's gonna update very quick. And if I go back to this website, I refresh it, all the updates are there. Now the navbar is visible. This text here has been changed as well. Now, if you want to make the designs responsive, all you have to do is go back to Framer, add a breakpoint here. So you have, by default, you have three options, the desktop, tablet, and phone. So I'm going to click on tablet, and one more time for phone. Now you see, obviously it's all cut off and it doesn't look nice. So I can just make some modifications to the design here. So I've made some modifications to the designs for the tablet and mobile phone view, just so they look nicer and none of the tags are cut off. And once you're done here, you can also, before publishing any changes, you can also go to the live preview by clicking this play button here. And you'll see how the site will look once it goes live. You can also click on full screen here, show UI to go back to the default size. You can change the view here. If you want to view the phone version, you can click there and see how this looks on a mobile phone. Once you're happy with the changes, you can just click on publish, update, and there we have it. Last thing, let's make the components for the buttons so they're actually interactive and you can put links. So if you click on the button layers here, same shortcut as in Figma, Control Alt K. Now it's gonna create a new component. Let's just call it button for now. And you can quickly create a hover state. Let's just say I want this to be solid when hovered, maybe a little bit darker, like so. You can also add a link here. If all the buttons are going to lead to only one link, you can just paste the URL here. Or if you want different buttons all over the page that takes you to different links, different sites, you can make the link as a variable. You can even adjust if you want each link to be a new tab or no. If it's not a new tab, you want it to be an instant scroll or a smooth scroll. If it stays on the same page, you can quickly preview this once again. See, the hover interaction is working perfectly. You can set variants, same as in Figma. Variants for different breakpoints, smaller buttons for smaller screens. And yeah, you can go to your browser here, refresh, make the size a little bit smaller so that you can see how, or you can also test this on your mobile phone as well, and see how the design looks on smaller breakpoints. So yeah, that's how you turn your designs on Figma into a live functioning site using Framer. I hope you guys find this video helpful. If you do, please do give it a like, consider subscribing, leave a comment, and I'll see you guys in the next one.